I should stop drinking and get the red rose from the abandoned house in the village. I want to commemorate my husband next to his grave, but first I need to tidy my home up a little. Let's start from the dirty windows. Now fix the alignment of pictures. Okay then. Before I leave, I need to look around if I miss something. After all, I am going on an adventure. Who knows? Of course, my pills! Now let's put on the boots and get going. How I wish I could run, but impossible for me with the high heels. and chicken swim? I asked him in a drizzly dawn. Of course, he replied. They can run into water and stay there as much as they want to. How come? I wondered. He laughed and told me that it depends how realistic the developer scripts the AI for the chicken. Years later, I played a game called Drizzlepath and finally got what he meant by that. Me and my sister Lara visited him at the morgue. He was just lying without fear of the past. Suddenly, all our memories came to life when I was close to him again. But it was different. He wasn't trying to make me smile like he always did. Maybe he was watching me, trying to tell me something about our last day together. Maybe he was angry about the mistakes I did. I saw him struggling the consequences of ignorance. And I came close to him and whispered, "It is over." There used to be seaplanes flying around our town. We often enjoyed watching them near the ocean. Eric mentioned that some of them were float planes. I laughed and said they are both the same things. Nope, he disallowed. There is a difference. Float planes have pontoons to take off or land on. Their body isn't intended to touch the water. He loved to make me feel ignorant. But I always sorted out by not talking to him for the rest of the day. Then again, he knew how to make me generous one way or another. Oh, my head. I need to take a pill. Foxes are major predators of hens, but when it comes to humans, they sometimes act as simple pets. If Eric were here now, he would act the guardian angel in such an unnecessary way. Sometimes he treated me like his little girl, with no teeth on her mouth. Getting help from him learning to drive was great pain because of his obsessions about trying to keep me secure. Now that he's not around, I miss everything about him. Even the least pleasing sides of his character make me sensitive. In order to open the sacred passage, I must fill this urn with blood. Should be able to find 3 amphoras filled with blood in this cave. I got all 3. Time to dive! It was a Sunday morning. I was going to clean the floor, but he took away the vacuum cleaner and threw out the window.
Why?
I asked, my hands shaking. It will be better there outside as an Easter egg, he said. Somebody will find it and never understand its purpose being there. That was so cryptic of him. I never found out what he meant. But it was definitely the first weird moment of our marriage. Wind has effect on mechanical elements, just like it has effect on water. I like to swim, but when I get out of water, and if it is windy, it makes goosebumps and feels... awful. Why am I telling this? I must focus on grabbing the red rose. It should be in the abandoned house. But where was the house? Somewhere in the village that I'm getting near. But which house was it? I guess I must try all the doors. They all lock their doors in this hour, but I should be able to open the one door. There's the village. The rose is in one of those houses. I should check their doors. Open it. Stuck. Locked. This should help me open the box upstairs. Okay, now I'll grab the rose and leave. Let's get the heck out of this village. I'll go to the pier and use a boat. I admit that I can walk a little faster on these high heels whenever I want to leave an area real quick. What was this curse thing anyway? It had to be some kind of a belief from an earlier era. I wonder if the creator wanted my heart to beat a little faster. The only thing I feel is the need to go to the pier, and there I will step on a little boat and sail to the other side. I just hope that nobody got harmed in the fire. can't believe I'm the reason for all this. Should I have reported to the fire department? One evening, Eric bought me a bouquet of betonies. I asked, from where and why? He didn't respond to my question, touched my hair, scanned me from head to foot, but still said nothing. Walked away to his studio room, turned on his PC. He started playing his favourite FPS game, Modern Offensive, with blank eyes. After a couple hours, he was done playing, so came back to me and said, I don't care about the violence in games, just wish it was only in virtuality. Maybe it's time we go to bed now. He was a difficult person to understand. Here I go again. Where's that freaking pill? I remember we were children, running in the fields with bare feet all day and going back home for supper. He used to tell me his dream about us. Walking together in Victorian gardens. I always thought those dreams would come true someday. Even if there would be no garden, we'd definitely be together. Sooner or later, those dreams would come true. If I knew how to ride a horse, this journey would take a lot less. there are new F12 model cameras. Should give it a try someday. Eric wasn't exactly a mingy type, but when it came to cars, I could never persuade him to buy a new one. He loved his old wreck, said his father gave it him on his 18th birthday, right after he graduated. It was sky blue, his favourite colour, and looked like a dead man walking. I remember its engine stopped working so many times. Those moments he never panicked. Got out of the car and fixed the engine in 10 minutes tops. Mechanics was kind of his speciality. At the college, we were at the same class. One day, it was a literature exam, and the teacher was about to see him cheating from the book. I saw that and started to sing with a loud voice. The teacher got mad and took my paper, so Eric got enough time to copy all the answers to his paper. Later, he couldn't decide to whom he had to feel more guilty, but when the school ended and I failed the class... What if we never met? I'd probably throw myself into the wild many more times than I actually did. He wasn't so into the nature. Especially he was afraid of forests. The trees felt like giant monsters to him. I am quite the opposite to that. I find peace in the shadow of the trees. When I was a child, my father built me a treehouse, and Eric never came near it. He used to say, "You're going to fall and die, and when you do, remember what I say." He was trying to keep me secure, even when he was a child. Thank you. Since I am at the centre of wild nature, of course there will be a subway station. I'll have a look inside. Let's drink for being alone. What is this place? Am I losing it? Tree. Makes no sense. I think I'm going to fast forward from here to the hill where the grave is.
Thank you.
8 years ago, we had been to Iceland. Coming back home near the airport, I was walking so fast, I didn't see a cab coming my way. There was no time to alert me, so he jumped into the air to push me, just like in the movies. Naturally, we both ended up in the hospital with a total of 6 broken bones. It was nice listening to his dreams every day in the bed. Mr. Adams, the doc, didn't want to discharge us from the hospital for some reason. We weren't afraid of heights, climbed high hills and even a mountain once. Eric didn't mind, as long as there are not so many trees, and loved to take photos of distant skies. And when it drizzled, I used to sing. And since his voice was terrible, he just played the bouzouki he got from Mykonos Island. Together, we even wrote a song for his car. The car that lived longer than Eric. On a rainy day, we were going to visit Lara's. While Eric was driving, I asked him, "What if lightning strikes the car? Will the tyres protect us?" He said, "It's just a myth. The reality is, yes, we're safe, but what's saving us is the car's metal cage." There, he did it again. I didn't talk to him that day. Thankfully for him, Lara was with us, and Eric didn't even notice my attitude. Life is so empty since he passed away. Everything feels like going up the hill, and I feel so close to the end. Am I ever going to see you again? Honestly, I'm not sure about what would have been my wish, and I don't know if you want to see me wherever you are. Deep inside, I miss you so much, but I try hard not to. Life changes all of us, but some things are always the same. Can being a bad dev who can't script proper AI be an achievement for anyone? If it was 2 years ago, I couldn't find the right answer for that. Lara always talks about Mr. Adams. She says the guy is so cool. But Eric used to mock Lara about it. He said, "The only way you talk to him is to get hit by a car." Eric loved to make Lara frustrated. Even when she was at college, he used to steal her books and return them after exams. I used to talk to him a lot about the situation, but he kept on resisting. Nothing changed, even though long years have passed in our lives. One more pill and that will do, I guess. Seaplanes, cars, bazookies, and so many more. It's been so long since I lost him, but it feels like everything reminds me of him. I'm here, and he's on the other side. There is just one bridge between us, and it's called death. I'm not afraid of seeing the other side, even if there is no return, and all my senses tell me that it is near. Should I pay him a visit? Would he want that? Sooner or later, I will find out. Cross the bridge, and we're there. Let's find the grave, since I totally forgot which one it was. love you, Eric. But that evening, when I caught you staring at Lara in a different way, that moment, the shard of glass seemed so friendly. Sorry. Not once upon a time.